think the hardest part of this prep so far has been, like, you know, like, me versus me. I want to, like, bring my best self, but it's been so long since I competed, and I do feel like I have a different package now. And, like, being this close to stage for the weight that I'm at, like, it makes me very nervous, because I don't really remember what I used to weigh, like, 2 weeks out before a show, but I feel like it was less than where I'm at right now. So when you just, like, look at the numbers, it panics. Like, it starts to panic me a bit. So I think the hardest part has just been, like, trying not to compare to other people I've been good with, but comparing to my previous self has made, like, it's just made it a bit challenging, because I don't know. All I know is that I feel like I'm doing everything I need to do. I feel like I've been working really hard, and, like, ultimately that's all that needs to matter. But it's also the hardest part too, because you don't know. Like, I feel like I don't know if it's good enough, or I don't know if, you know, will I be ready? That kind of, like, thought process wasn't really there before, and now, like, the 3 week out point is when, like, some of the self-doubt started creeping back in, and that made this past week, like, really hard for me. So this past week in general was really hard. Thinking about numbers makes it hard. So I'm just trying, I need to try to not think, and then maybe things won't be so hard. What have I learned about myself throughout this prep? I know I've definitely learned that, planning and preparing and, like, thinking ahead and getting myself prepared for the day, for the week, makes my life so much easier. And maybe that sounds like common knowledge, but I'm not much of a planner, preparer. I'm kind of like fly by the seat of my pants kind of girl. I've always been that way. This is the first prep I've really taken the planning process seriously, in terms of planning my meals, in terms of thinking about how my week looks at work, for my workouts, my weekend, and trying to really balance it all and make it all fit, so that one area of my life didn't seem so chaotic that, you know, I couldn't handle it all. And I feel like I really have been able to do that without like losing myself in the process. Like, I feel like I've been able to still go to work every week and be present at work as the department head. And I've still been able to come home on weeknights and I feel like be somewhat present for my husband or for my family or friends or whatever I'm doing. I feel like I've been able to do that. So I think in this prep, like, even though there are still some self-doubts I have, like, it's made me realize, like, I am a much stronger person than what I give myself credit for. And, you know, I'll always have, like, a little bit of that self-doubt and insecurity, but the fact that I've been able to do it all, and, you know, maybe I won't bring the leanest package or the best package to stage, but I feel like, you know, I've worked my ass off harder than I ever have for any other prep. I feel like I learned that about myself, that I am strong. You know, I do push myself really hard, and, you know, I deserve to give myself some credit for that. Yeah, I mean, I think I can actually make a lot of comparisons between, like, training for a marathon and running a marathon and training for a competition and actually competing on show day. You know, with training for a marathon, it's the same type of concept. Like, you're building up for months, for weeks, for that one day where you can either be on point and be your best self, or you can fuck it all up, or you can be nervous, or you just don't have your day. And the same is true for competing in a bodybuilding show. You work hard day in and day out, all your eating choices, all your workouts, your stress levels, it all impacts that one day. And sometimes it's your day and sometimes it's not. And there's so many factors that you can't always control the impact at. And I know I was thinking too, like, because my last competition, I did on show day. Like, I just wanted it to be over with. I wanted it to be done with. And I didn't really enjoy the day in itself. And it did make me think of, like, training and running for a marathon, because as nervous as I always was to run a marathon, because I would put a lot of pressure on myself the same way I would for a competition, in terms of like, this is the time I want to get, or I want to beat this time, and I want to feel really good the whole time and not want to puke or crap my pants. And the same is true for like a bikini competition or bodybuilding competition. Like, I want to go into that day, yeah, nervous with butterflies, but I want to enjoy the day. I want to enjoy the moment. I want to be present in the moment and not be thinking about, well, I can't wait for this to be over so I can go eat. You know, I want to be present in the moment and really take it all in and enjoy it and appreciate it. And that's truly what I try to do when I run a marathon, or when I previously ran marathons. So it's funny, because I was thinking about that the other day, that I don't want to go into this day so nervous or like doubting myself so much that I can't just appreciate it and, you know, appreciate myself and enjoy it. So hopefully I can do that on show day. I think the funnest part of prep has been changing up my workouts, because I didn't really feel like I was in like a lull with my workouts, but going back to Well-Rounded when I hadn't been there in 2 years and working out with trainers and having people push me outside of my comfort zone was eye-opening, because I always felt like I did a really good job at it, and then I went back there and it was like an ego check, like, okay girl, drop the weights, lower it down, and, you know, check your ego at the door. And it was a lot of fun though. It's been a lot of fun training, and like training with that purpose. Like, I'm always pretty good about training, even if it's not for like a competition. I have a love for training. It goes up and down sometimes. I'll have my weeks where I just have no desire to work out. But it's been really fun to feel like I have that purpose and to have that goal that's been driving me every single day. Like, I haven't like struggled with going to the gym. It's just been, that part has been fairly easy for me for the most part. And don't mistake that with I'm not tired and exhausted and complain about it sometimes, but it's been fun to have that goal in the back of my mind, kind of that fire in my belly and that drive to really work as hard as I can and push as hard as I can, and, you know, to see the changes happening. So that's been good. I've went through like post-competition depression, same with like running marathons too. Like, anytime I think you have this big like fitness goal and you're working so hard for something, and you feel like you have purpose, right? And you feel like, you know, not that you're like extra important or special, but it just makes you, it gives you that focus. And when it's done, it can hit you super hard. I've had it happen after both. And usually my go-to is to focus on another goal and to find another goal, whether it's picking another competition because I want to continue to compete, or whether it's, you know, making improvements to my physique still, or maybe it's just going back to having fun workouts and without a purpose, but without like a set goal. For me right now, I think I have to cross that bridge when I get there and see how I feel after the show day. But in a way, I hope that I do compete again beyond this competition, and that maybe I will again in 2015. If not, I am also coaching bikini clients now, so I feel like that'll give me, like, even if I'm not training for a competition, helping others achieve that goal, I think will give me some satisfaction to not like feel depressed afterwards. So following a if it fits your macros approach, you do have to be like ready to deal with the cuts. Whereas when I was doing a meal plan, I didn't have to like think about that so much. Like, we would occasionally like change stuff, but it wasn't like, you know, you were getting cut down. So you have to be like mentally able to handle that. And that, I've been following flexible dieting for a while now, like a year and a half, so I knew that part would be a little bit tough, which is funny because at the very beginning I was on super high macros, and was like, I don't want to be eating this much. Like, just cut me down. Let's get me lean. You know, you don't enjoy it while you have it kind of thing. And then as macros got cut lower and lower, it does get tough. But I just kind of like, instead of getting so anxious and like overworked or even overthinking it, I just told, like, I kind of like would amp myself up for the challenge. Like, this is just one more challenge, Kara. This is one more thing that's going to make you stronger, that's going to give you results, that you're going to push through, and you're just going to give 100%. And, you know, it's not forever. And, you know, that's kind of just what I told myself, like, one day at a time. I wouldn't even be like, oh, 6 more weeks till the competition, you can do this. It was more like, one day at a time, just focus on the day at hand, whether macros were low or not, like, just kind of taking it one day at a time. And, you know, as macros got really low, which they are still right now, I've just had to kind of like come up with my own ways of doing things to make it a little bit easier. And like, not like, because sometimes you can feel depressed when your diet gets very low, and that's where I think intermittent fasting did help me, has helped me. Eating in a shorter window of time, so even though I'm eating a smaller amount, I can still eat and feel satisfied, and that's just worked easier for me. And in the past, like, carb cycling had helped me too, but I think that's been the easiest way for me to deal with the cut of macros, as well as sugar-free Jell-O. That's helped me considerably, and drinking lots of fluids. I drink a lot. I hold a lot of water, but I drink a lot so that it helps fill up my stomach. So I've just kind of learned my own tricks at this point for what works for me to keep me on track. Am I gonna do anything to get myself psyched up on show day? I think I probably will be psyched up, I hope. Like, a big reason for me wanting to do this competition, as I've mentioned, is that I want to enjoy the experience, including the day of, which is something that I always sell myself short on. So I don't know. Like, I don't know what specifically I would do to get pumped up, but, like, probably, like, read some YouTube comments, because you guys always write awesome stuff that pumps me up. Maybe I'll take a little pre-workout on show day to pump me up. I don't know if that's allowed. I'll have to ask Mark to see what he thinks. But I don't know. It's like, there's so many other people competing that I follow on social media. That's helped keep me pumped up. Britney Spears gets me pumped up. So I'll probably listen to some Britney Spears in the hotel room the morning of. Till the world ends. That's my jam right there. That's my power song. No matter what mood I'm in, I listen to that song and I get super happy. So yeah, I sound like a dork right now, but that's my power song. It works for me. So I don't usually listen to music like on headphones or anything before I go on stage, but I think since I don't think I know anyone competing in this show. Like, a lot of the past shows, I've known people or connected with people on YouTube to meet up. And I don't know anyone competing in this show. So maybe I will just, like, sit and listen to music before I go on stage to kind of stay in my own head, stay motivated, and not, like, focus on anyone else. Because it does get hard when you're there and you start seeing all the other girls that look shredded and incredible. And, oh, she's got smaller legs than me and her boobs are ginormous. And you start doing all that stuff to yourself that knocks down your self-esteem before you walk on stage. So maybe I'll give that a try this time. Hope you guys enjoyed this little mini Q&A about my bikini prep. If you enjoyed it, please give it a thumbs up. And if you'd like to see another one of these before my competition, please comment below. As always, thank you all for your support and keep checking back. This is a little Victoria's Secrets pink bikini. A little something different. Just thought it was fun, the hot pink. Little bit of abs.
Super cute.
And I'm hungry. This is a long time to wait to eat. All right, bud. Don't lick my leg. I'm not a human popsicle.